Hey guys, Ashley DeWill here. I hope everybody is doing well today. I recently did a video called Be Open, and then I did one about the prayer of Jehoshaphat. And I want to encourage all of you who received those messages into your heart. I want to encourage all of you who are still standing. And so the name of this video is called Who's Left Standing? Well, the Lord is calling His body close to Himself, and to stand in Him and with Him as He does things behind the scenes. And He's going to slowly reveal these things. Some will come crashing through, and some will be revealed like turning up the dial on the oven. Just very slowly they'll be revealed. So I want to share with you just some encouragement for those of you who haven't caved or flaked out or gone, taking a left turn. I want to encourage you to continue to stand. Be open to what the Lord is doing now that we don't see behind the scenes. And when it does come crashing through or is slowly unveiled, that you will be rejoicing that you were in agreement with Him, staying lined up with Him. Everyone who is not staying aligned with the Lord, it's okay. You have time to line yourself back up. Okay, let's look at a couple of things that happen when the Lord calls people to stand with Him. And it's almost like Peter on the water. His eyes are on Christ. He says yes. He starts to walk. But then something happens. He takes his eyes off of Christ and he looks down at the waves. See, that's what happens when you fall out of alignment with the Lord. You start to use your five senses to define reality, and that is carnality, remember? So if we start out, say, with 20 people, when the Lord calls us to walk with Him and stand in something that really doesn't make sense to us, maybe let's just say there's 20 people. After a while, there'll be only 15. See, we're finding out who's left standing. 20, 15, then 10. Then a little while later, there's only 5 left. And then after a while, it can be that there are 3, 2, and only 1 person left standing. I hope that we don't get that low. I hope that maybe we've just come here or here. But for those of you who may have come down here, you can always come back up and line yourself back up with the Lord. Let's talk real quick about what stand means. What does it mean to stand? It means to make to stand. That means I'm making myself stand. It's a choice that we have, and we can do that. We have the choice to stand, and we often need the help of the Holy Spirit if we're feeling weak or our knees are wobbly to help us to stand, and He can hold us up while we stand to see the salvation of the Lord. It also means stand means to establish. And so this goes to establishing your heart, your mind, your being, your whole life on the rock. You are established. That means you are not moving. You're not moving to the left, not moving to the right. Your knees aren't shaking. You're not looking at the waves. You're not getting nervous. You're not falling into fear. You are established. You are established. Like when the roots of your being grow deep into Christ. They can shake you on the top, but you're not going to move because your roots are way down there, very sturdy and established. Stand also means to set in balance. That means you're in balance of what is in reality in the spirit, so that you can't be thrown off balance by things in the natural. It means to place oneself, and this goes back to make to stand, because we make the choice to stand, and we ask the Holy Spirit to help us to stand. Okay, the last one is to stand firm. When we are standing, we don't stand in a flimsy way. We don't stand in a wimpy way. We don't stand and look around and wait for anything to blow us over and then just fall. No, you stand. And nothing can move you when you are standing on the rock and you've established your heart on the rock. This is what the scripture teaches us, and this is what I'm encouraging you to do. Ephesians 6:13 talks about standing, and it's mainly referring to He's talking about the armor and everything and standing against the enemy. But in 13, he says, stand. And he's referring to one who vanquishes his adversaries and holds his ground. That is how you vanquish your adversaries, by holding your ground. When you are persuaded by something outside to move or to fall or to move and turn against where you were standing, that is a real problem. Okay? So you want to be one who vanquishes his adversaries and holds his ground. Holds it. That means you do not move. In verse 11, it's referring, the standing there is referring to one who amidst the fight, do you know there's a fight going on? A tremendous, colossal, epic fight going on. One who amidst the fight holds his position against the foe. Are you holding your position against the foe? That's the question. If you are, you will be left standing. If you're not holding your position, you will flake out, fall away, cave in. All right? So what happens? What causes us to get wobbly or get afraid or start to lean to our own understanding? There are all these different factors that can come in, and we need to look at some of those. What would make you, if you're not still standing or left standing, what has made you waver in your standing? What has made you move from where you were? It reminds me of Galatians 3, where Paul says, who has bewitched you? Who has bewitched you or persuaded you in another direction? When, if you've wavered, you've moved, or you've fallen from standing, what are some of the things that can cause you to do that? What are some of the temptations or the lures of the enemy? Unbelief. Unbelief. Some people have a very small measure of faith, and they can only stand for a day or a week. They don't know the long-term picture, and they don't see the big picture of what's going on. So unbelief can really knock you off your rocker. Doubt is another dart of the enemy. It will cause you to falter. Human understanding, oh, we've talked a lot about that. Human understanding will never understand the Spirit. Human understanding doesn't know the Lord. Human understanding is basically worthless. So if you're listening to that, that is probably why you have fallen or moved or wavered or gotten knocky knees or caved or flaked out. The words of man, when we listen to the words of man and the fear of man is a snare. And if you listen to the words and the fear of man, you will be snared. Fake news is the words of man. Fake news is the news of this world system. Satan is the god of this world, and Satan is the father of lies. So the media that is controlled by him is going to be fake news. It's a curtain, like on the Wizard of Oz, for you to believe certain things. But for some of us, the Lord pulls back the curtain, and we see what's behind it, and we're trying to share that with you. We're trying to get you to walk in union with that, in unity, in alignment with that. So also, another thing that can make you waver, move, or fall is the New World Order smoke screens. They're all around us. It's really the Matrix. So you have to know, are you a blue pill or are you a red pill? I'm a red pill. Some of you may be blue pills and you may want to turn into a red pill. Ask the Lord what He would want you to do in that. Lies are another thing, of course, that can cause us to fall and have trouble, deception and falsity, and then fear. Fear is a big one as well. Okay, so who's left standing? I want to ask that now. I want to ask it in a few days. I want to ask it in a week. I want to ask it in 2 weeks. I want to ask it in 3 weeks. I want to ask it in 2 months, 3 months, 4 months. As all of this starts to come out, who will be left standing with the Lord? That's what the Lord wants to know. Who's with Him and who's on board with what He's doing, even when our puny, wimpy, worthless human understand doesn't really know what's going on? Who's still standing in their spirit of discernment, lining up with the Lord? All right, so this is just to encourage you. If you are still standing, to continue standing, and if you have fallen or wavered or gotten weak, or turned away, to come back and line back up with the Lord, because He hasn't budged. And if we're in Christ, we don't need to budge. All right? So you guys have a blessed day, and I'll see you soon.